what they usually look like. Okay, sorry.
So it's 6:30.
Text dinner. So 6:31, she'll probably be coming soon. Roll call. I'll call the meeting to order at 6:31.
Connie Johns.
Here.
Jim Grabowska.
I'm here.
Jack May.
Here.
Sean Coons.
Here.
Jillian Cousins. Johanna Marzinski. Here.
Okay. Introduction of visitors.
Dan Miller.
Is that her answering? Okay. Anybody else back there? No. So Jillian is here. First thing on the agenda is approval of agenda.
I move approval.
Tom had sent out an email suggesting that we maybe pull some uniform contract because he had some questions he was still waiting for answers for. So I make a motion that we remove number 11 from the agenda for tonight.
Okay, so we have, how are we going to write this up? We've got two motions floating out there.
Oh, I'm going to pull my motion.
All right. So there's a motion.
Because it wasn't seconded either.
Right, to pull that number whatever.
Number 11,
yeah.
I'll
second that.
And seconded to pull number 11 on the agenda. Further discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Carries? Now I suppose we need a new motion to approve the agenda?
I'll do it.
Okay, is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, say aye.
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 Opposed, carries. Number two, positive recognition. Kelly, are you doing that one?
Sure. Tom had put in the agenda to thank everyone, the technology staff and office staff, for a great job on preparing for the new school year. And then I have a few donations. I have one to add to the list as well. We received $150 worth of school supplies, books, and calculators from Brenda Cruz. And we received $300 from Special Olympics to go towards this next sophomore inclusion event. And then I received $500 from Jack May for the Bisey Memorial Fund in memory of his mom, Pat May. So thank you for all of those.
Okay, good. Number three, PTO power takeoff report.
Two main things. We did like a back to the grind event with the teachers last week, and that was a big hit, just coffee and hot chocolate and stuff like that. So that was our first teacher appreciation. And then our fundraiser kicked off on Friday the 13th. So we're 10 days in. Our goal this year is 20,000. We bumped it up from our 17 last year. We're hoping the playground addition motivates people a little bit. Thanks to Ms. Holland for adding that. We're excited to be contributing to that. We're at about 7,500 so far on that. So that was a great 10 days to start with. We're going to do a fun run again that Wednesday before MEA. The kids seem to like that. We did revamp the prize structure a little bit this year, so the kids are getting them as they go, and it seems to be keeping the excitement up a little bit this year. So the other thing that we're considering that may have eventually come across to you guys is, and the roller skates are every other year, so this would be the year that they would rent the roller skates. It sounds like there was some research being done on whether we could purchase that rather than rent them every year, and then even possibly rent them out to other schools in the surrounding areas. The other thing to consider with that is logistics and storage, of course, and so that all things that we would have to play into, and it usually comes around in the early spring-ish, but something we would consider with this year's fundraiser money as well.
Okay, thank you. Number four, any unfinished business? Number five, open forum for items on the agenda. And I haven't seen any indication there that somebody has a card or anything. Then consider the consent agenda items. Does anybody have anything they want to pull and focus on separately?
I'd move approval.
Okay, there's a motion to approve the consent agenda.
I'll second.
Who wants that?
Julie.
Okay, any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed, motion carries. Number seven, long-term sub-approval.
Cassandra Keeney is on family leave, which was approved by the board, and Ann Linnell has been serving as her long-term sub. Due to the length of that absence, it actually puts Ann on the teacher contract for the time that she's here, and so we're asking for approval of her time here as a substitute teacher.
I would move to accept the appointment of Ann Linnell as presented.
Second.
Motion has been made and seconded. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed, carries. Number eight, appointment. Elizabeth McDonald, do you have anything to elaborate there?
Nope, she meets the needs of our students. She's a quality candidate, so.
Okay.
I'll make a motion to approve the appointment of Elizabeth.
Motion has been made and seconded to approve that position. Further discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed, motion carries. Number nine, resolution requesting grant funds from the Minnesota State High School League. Elaborate on that besides
it
It's just, we need a resolution from the board. It's part A of the fundraiser or the grant money. It's based off of free and reduced lunch. So it's just more or less, we give them the numbers, they give us a check back for based off the number of kids we have in free and reduced lunch.
I move approval of the resolution.
Jim has introduced the resolution.
Second.
Duly seconded by Sean.
Alright, Connie Johns.
Yes.
Jim Gabowski.
Yep.
Jack May.
Yes.
Sean Coons.
Yes.
Jillian Cousins.
Yes.
Johanna Marzinski, yes.
Whereupon the resolution was declared duly passed and adopted. Number ten, that's what I, State High School League applicant, cooperative sponsor, okay, this one maybe we could use some more elaboration.
Yeah, we've had requests over the years for gymnastics, and we kind of have asked the Mankato district. It's normally based off of a need base for them. We have two girls right now that are interested in gymnastics. They've been through the gymnastics school over the last how many years. Mankato East is in need of bodies, so they co-op with Mankato Loyola and Medelia over the last few years. Mankato Loyola has not had a gymnast for the last 6-7 years, so they will dissolve their co-op on that one and add us if we're willing, which would still keep them, Mankato East, in the same classification. So our recommendation is to add gymnastics as a activity to offer here at St. Clair. We will not supply any transportation to the practices and or events. That's the responsibility of the parent. But we will pay for our fee into the State High School League.
In other words, we're not going to bend over backwards.
Or do splits over it.
That's
I
look
approval
at
of the cooperative sponsorship.
I will second it.
Okay. Is there any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Number 12, community education bylaw.
When do we anticipate putting out a call for the membership on the board?
We would probably put in the next newsletter asking for people that are interested.
Social media also?
Yes.
Suppose. Okay, and then there's an item in the
material.
So no one has made a motion yet. Is there a motion?
Yep,
yeah.
It is passed.
Number 14.
13, same question.
No, that's what we just did. Oh, no,
no,
sorry.
You're right.
That's what's happening.
Yep.
There is an item in our material on flexible learning that helps students and parents understand. More to elaborate on that.
What prompted it?
With flexible learning, you have to have it approved at the beginning of the year in case we choose to do flexible learning days during the school year. Do you remember when we approved the calendar? I think the first 5 days would be face-to-face makeup, anything. I think it was up to 5 votes. And then days after that would be used as an e-learning flexible learning day.
In the event that we would have a winter like we had last year, on the 6th day would be when our staff came up with a plan that includes what everyone would be responsible for on those days.
I move approval.
I have one more question. So the guidelines that were in our packet, would those be something that's going to be kind of condensed to send out to the parents or in the newsletter?
Yeah.
Kind of to pre...
The first document that's in the packet where it says frequently answered
yep,
or asked questions,
that one.
That's kind of the down and dirty
okay.
that I think would be most easily understood by parents.
Right.
The other document would be available as well, and it really
okay.
lays out very well. Parents, this is what we expect you to do on these days. Students, this is what we expect you to do. It has guidelines for the hours that teachers are going to be available and all of that.
Right.
This information, as part of the plan, it talks about how we're going to get this information out to families too. So there will be information that goes into the district newsletter, and you know we'll share that information with families. We'll have at the elementary anyway. I know we'll have some information about it should it be passed
right.
at our conferences in November. So
okay.
that parents can ask questions as well. I'm sure high school will probably go out electronically because that's the way that parents seem to respond best at your level, I think.
And I assume the staff, since they had good input into putting together, are all on board.
They
put
it together.
It's
all from the
staff.
All from
yeah.
the staff, yeah. Okay.
Are the absences, so when they, it was like the third day, I think, when they take attendance for the flex day, is that going to be for elementary as well, or is that just mostly high school, since it's...
That would be for elementary as
okay.
well, because we recognize that there are some students who may not have access to internet if
okay.
we have a snow day,
okay.
and we wanted to make sure that we gave them a little bit of flexibility in getting their work done once they do have access here in the building.
Okay.
Just intuitively, or shooting from the hip, do you have a feel for whether it's just a few outliers that don't have access or more
yeah,
than that?
Yeah, we did an informal survey just at the elementary 3 or 4 years ago, and there were 5 or 6 children total who did not have internet in their home.
Does that include mobile? And is this material or?
I don't have the answer to that, but I'm assuming at the high school it's...
The last set, I think Mr. Gottberg did the survey, he said 4 families in the entire district did not have internet access at home. So.
Now, in the event of a major storm, you're dealing with other things where maybe no one has internet in their
right.
homes because we have electricity knocked out and those sorts of things, but we roll with that as it comes.
Mobile compatible? Because those are 2 separate questions, right?
Yes.
Internet access,
correct.
You're talking about
correct.
Something that is distinct from cellular.
It should be mobile compatible.
Okay.
And if we know it's coming, we have, please remind me what the devices are called that they can check out.
Kahoot, not Kahoot, Kajits.
Kajits, yes. So if we have an idea that there's some bad weather coming, we could send those kids down that we know would need cellular access, and we could have them take that home with them and be proactive, because in this day and age, it's not like a lot of this catches us off guard anymore.
Mm-hmm. So, if I recall right, Jim made a motion to approve that. Is that where we left off?
Yep.
Yep.
I'll second.
Any further discussion?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. And we have a couple of sort of housekeeping items for MSU and Adolphus, Justus Davis, for student teachers. Anything to elaborate on those?
I'd move both contracts, 14 and 15.
Wow.
Second both.
Motion's been made and seconded to approve both
further discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? All in favor say aye.
Snow removal quote.
No change, so I'd move approval.
That's what we'll last for.
I have a really quick question on that one. Does he just do the parking lot, or does he do the sidewalks as well all around?
The sidewalks are done by our custodial staff.
I know on that one winter was so bad, like on the agency side there, they would just take and scoop most of it off of the sidewalk to open it up a bit for traffic, you know, would pile up there. Otherwise the.
Okay. I just know there was a few incidences last year. It was really icy last year, so it just concerned me, like, who's gonna.
That's something that we should check, and to have him do the sidewalks, just kind of free up the resources here.
Well, I think that'll, you know, we approve the extra custodian, so maybe it'll depend on if we get something in place, you know, with all of that. But if we don't, that's a good question to see if we can add that on to free up.
Resource.
Right, yeah, I'll send a message to Tom.
I'll make a motion to approve the snow removal quote.
Okay, any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carries. Record destruction report, another housekeeping item.
Yep, every so often we deal with that fun, tedious thing. The historical, when I first started, the Minnesota Historical Society had the record retention schedule that we followed, and since then they don't care. And so it's really up to districts. I get information from Region 5 on, you know, those types of things, but otherwise we're really following it, and we just really want to make sure and keep track of whenever we do shred things, and so we have that record, but it's kind of a last priority usually, so.
I move approval.
I'll second it.
Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carries. Number 18, upon board research and MSBA's presentation and search proposal, it's the recommendation to use MSBA as a partner to the superintendent search for Mr. Brewer's replacement.
I will make a motion.
Second.
Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carries. Proposed 2019-2020 tax levy.
Okay,
40 pages, right?
Yep. The complete document is in your packet. I should have noted also on page 31 is the summary page. So this is the September meeting, is just the meeting that we always approve the maximum, so we don't need to actually approve a dollar amount. And that's actually what MDE always recommends as well, because there's tiny little adjustments, then you're not dealing with keeping on, or, you know, continuously reapproving it. So right now with the preliminary levy, we're looking at a 1.63% increase, so pretty minimal. So in December is when we will do the final dollar amount, the final levy, after we've gone through the truth and taxation hearing that everyone looks forward to every year.
I'll make a motion to approve the proposed amount.
Motion has been made and seconded to approve the levy as reported here. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carries. Policies first reading are, as you can see there, they'll be on the consent agenda, so we'll want to use those. 21.
just want to say thank you to my elementary staff and the PTO for partnering up for our back-to-school social again. It ran very smoothly, and we had just a ton of people here. I don't know how much ice cream we went through. I know that Mrs. Cumberland had to go and buy more. I know we went through 600 bowls, so there were a lot of people.
How many did you have, Jack?
And I also want to thank Mr. Pegram. He did an orientation meeting for all the fifth and sixth grade band students, and that was very, very well received by those parents who attended that. And then I also really want to commend my staff on the beginning of the school year, because the increased enrollment that we've had both at the elementary and the high school level created some unique situations with scheduling and space, and they have done a very nice job of being creative and solving some of those problems and coming up with great ideas that have worked very well for the students and made the best of the resources that we have.
The other bullet point there was covered in the power takeoff report. I guess I ran out of when I printed this. So, high school principal's report.
Nothing real new to add there, except I would like to point out homecoming last week. I think you have to commend our student body for their behavior during the week. This is not my favorite week of the year, but I have very little or few problems amongst the students. They conducted themselves extremely well, and when we had our talent show, we had a student that, lack of a better term, kind of froze during her presentation, and the student body just kind of cheered her on and got her through that moment, and just really conducted themselves incredibly well. I think I was standing by someone from that had been in another district, and they just kind of looked at me like, your kids actually do this here? Wow. At the school that I was at, they would have just roasted her, and our kids were just incredible. So I keep saying our kids are incredible, our kids are really good, and they just keep displaying it, and so kudos to them.
That's awesome. So Nadine, I mean, not to take anything away from anyone, we've had PBIS since 10, 12 years that I've been on the board. Do you think that's, you know, coming to
transfer? We're talking about
transfer. Oh, definitely. I think we have a really nice alignment K-12, because we do the PBIS, but then once they get to 7-12, they do their random acts of kindness and kind of take it to a little bit more grown-up level than we do at the elementary, and so I think the combination of the two definitely makes a difference.
I guess I was just curious as to how good we feel about those programs versus just pure luck that we have this kind of.
I don't think it's pure luck. I really think it's what the elementary does, and then just the expectations that our staff, all our staff, not just the teachers, but our staff gives for the kids and then holds them to expectations, and the willingness of the kids to reach those expectations and want to be successful, want to help kids. I overheard one of the football players, one of the freshmen, say that he came in new last year as an eighth grader, and I overheard him, he didn't know I was standing there, make a comment, this wouldn't happen at my other school. The kids are just so nice here. They include you, they don't mistreat you. Now, don't get me wrong, there's bullying that goes on, and if an administrator says it doesn't happen, they're lying to you. But I think our kids respond really well when we hear about it, we address it, and we take care of it. And I think some of these kids just at times will step in and prevent kids from picking on each other, and they set a good example. So.
Good.
Well, you got three here.
They look like
agree
trouble.
Agree or disagree with that statement? Now, if that's not a resounding endorsement.
Sold.
All right, so I don't think we have. Did Tom pass anything along to anyone that needs to be covered? Okay, so we'll move on to board reports.
I was to the city council meeting beginning of the month, and the big excitement there was the waste treatment plant loan is completely paid off, so kudos to the city for that. Lift station by the post office was just about being finished, it maybe is done by now. So if we do have flooding, that should eliminate some of the issues in town with back flooding of the sewers and stuff. Other than that, there was nothing that I took away. Anything, Cindy, that you thought we should know about?
No, hopefully mitigation is finally wrapping up now, so after 3 years, we're going to revamp some of our MEVA money finally.
Okay.
So.
Backers, they had the Backers Bash, was a seemed to be a good success for that at the time. So next year, hopefully, we turn it into a fundraising event instead of an appreciation event. Other than that, I think the football game, Brad, I heard a lot of good comments about how the people could go up on the track and get closer to that game.
You have to get a positive once in a while.
So people liked it.
With a nice crowd.
Very well done.
I attended the MVED meeting a month before last, but I wasn't able to give it since I was absent last meeting. So MVED entered a one-year contract with the Speech Partners Therapy with the means of telepractice. And then MVED started their positive behavioral interventions and support training to become an official PBIS school too.
Any others? Okay. So for anyone that would like to speak about something other than what's on the agenda, open forum.
Do the young gentlemen have any questions or input or thoughts? Don't need further information, I think we talked about tonight? No?
Probably get extra credit in some class.
I say credit for class.
They just have to show up.
You didn't think they came here of their own.
Well, yes, I thought they were potential government employees.
Yeah.
I'm glad to see your school year going good?
Yeah.
Good.
Okay.
Just a note for everybody, I will not be at the October meeting. I will be in Arizona getting my newest daughter here. So.
Oh. Place or
Arizona.
Arizona,
yeah. Oh, it's
nice. All right. Is there a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
Okay. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
7:02.
It's kind of embarrassing. Can you stretch it out a little bit?
Good job. It's good. It's okay.
And the video.